lazima nishukuru wabunge wenu waliosema no kwa mambo ya finance bill last year. Na pia ni waombe mwaka huu tena, sababu finance bill 2024 hii ndio mbaya zaidi kuliko ile ya 2023. Wanaenda kuongeza bei kwa kila kitu, sababu Uhuru Kenyatta, na nataka nieleze watu wetu wa Kenya kwanza, there was wisdom in why sisi na Uhuru Kenyatta tulisema mambo ya essential goods, commodities zile zinatumika na kila mwananchi kwa nyumba, mambo ya mkate, vitu ya kawaida, ziwe zero rated, tusiweke ushuru hapo. Hawa wako wanasema kwa finance bill 2024 ushuru unaenda 16, unatoka 0% kwa mkate na vitu mnatumia kwa nyumba zenu, unaenda 16%. Mwaka jana ilitoka 8% na mafuta ikaenda 16%. Mwaka huu sasa wanaleta kwa vitu mnatumia kwa nyumba zenu, from 0% pale Uhuru aliwacha, inaenda 16%. So hata kunywa chai, mapasta wetu ama bishop, chai na mkate, inaenda kuwa sio kitu rahisi kwa familia. Mambo ya vyakula kutoka nje, hapa tuko border, watu wengi tunatoa vitu Uganda, si ndio? Anything itakuja sasa kutoka upande ule, bei iko inaenda wapi? Juu. Mafuta ya kupika kina mama, edible oil, bei inaenda wapi?
Our enemy is not ODM. Our enemy is not Raila. But I hope the enemy of these people is the government meeting their demands. Ni kini ko jopuonj ndik jopuonj maduong mang'eny moloyo. When the employing teachers, if they are 40,000 and Luos need 10,000, give them 10,000, don't give them 2,000. That's the enemy. If you are building roads in central Kenya and Rift Valley, give us our fair share of roads. That's our enemy. If you are employing army people, give us our fair share of army people. If you are doing markets, that is how you will win these people. If you don't do that, Raila will go to the AU, another Raila will come up. I can assure you. But these people respond to what government does positively, if government is positive with them. Kawati mayo, what's that kawati mayo? Ni, si, jasiko ken ODM. Jasiko ensiri kal chupotwarawa. Yes, you can see calling and only this country is run equitably. So that if a Kikuyu gets a road, a Luo also gets a road. If a Kalenjin gets a market, a Luo also gets a market. That's what we want. And I say this now that I'm a Kenya Kwanza, I'm part of the coalition, but this region for a long time was sidelined. For a long time, we've seen things happening in the rest of the world and they don't happen. And so we're going to compare our hopes. Rais alikuwa hapa kwetu mwaka jana. And he promised so many things. And these people are just not telling you. Uchanda hapo, yule jamuwa langata, namita kule Migori. People are asking us. Iko wapi zile vitu mlipromisiwa? So let's deal with that. Before you do these UDA elections, let's work with the people. In fact, that because you're one rising, because you're one rising, so that we talk to the people, the ground is soft. May God bless you.
We only need to redefine the kind of relationship that we are to have or we are having with the government. There must be some firm confirmations. And those who want to confirm are nobody other than our people. Those are the ones who want to confirmations. Partly, David Ocheng has alluded to it, the Lang has also said it, we are not regretting. We are not regretting. I think, Hobbs, this is what we need to take with you. The president came along, we were with him here last year. It was good. But then, you followed with a number of letters in terms of implementation of some of the promissory statements of the president. I think that's the best that we can ask from you. By end of Friday next week, our budget is out. Our budget staff, the national estimates for 24-25 is out. We want to plead with you. that can you do what you can, such that some of those promissory projects that the president made in front of our people, these people are very, very happy. And there are not many projects. Some of them, if we have them included in the next estimates for this country, it will be a firm and a good confirmation that we are working with the government. It's just as simple as that. It's something that we want to continue with. At the time we're getting to work with the government, we're also fully aware that others are coming, and they are coming to join.
We have to work together. And in working together is when we can realize and give our people the services and the dreams that they need. We cannot keep on lying to our people. We cannot lie to our people anymore. Let's come out and work with the current Anaja ODM. Tongichi Maruto no se konani korowe party ni idonja mo e UDA. No kono wake no watu sechete. Ni watiuru kumurachiel mundu watini nyopi. You must be a person who takes a stand. If you take a stand and this is the direction you're taking, you're supporting the president, you work with the president, come out and say it. Don't lie to our people.
My appeal over and above issues, Jack, is for the people of Nyanza to embrace the government. Embrace the government. You know the voting patterns that we witnessed during the last elections. But despite that, as we speak today, the president has made 139 key appointments in his government, something that has not been seen since independence in this country. That is from the four counties, Luo counties of Nyanza alone. If you augment with Kisi and Nyamira, we have over 200 appointees in this William Ruto government. So for the first time since independence, we have got a government that is truly interested in the welfare of this community.